Okay, hello Cloud Gurus. Well, this month we find ourselves on a bit of a VMware kick with two new VMware courses and a release review that takes a close look at VMware Cloud on AWS. We're also announcing our newest original series. It's really cool. And we're going to take a look at disaster control in the latest episode of Future of Tech. And we also roll out a Teams feature for our ACG for Business members. I'm Sam Kroonenberg, CEO and co-founder of Cloud Guru, and I'm really excited to show you what we've been really busy working on this month. As companies adopt cloud, VMware Cloud on AWS gives them the option of natively integrating and migrating their VMware private infrastructure to AWS. In our new VMware Cloud on AWS management course, Daniel Stinchcombe teaches us how to use VMware Cloud on AWS for globally distributing workloads, building cloud-based disaster recovery, and integrating AWS services with VMware-based applications. This course will help you prepare for the VMware Cloud on AWS management exam, and it's recommended for experienced VMware users who are already certified and have pretty advanced knowledge of the VMware product suite. If that's you, then this course is a really awesome way to expand your skills to include VMware on AWS. VMware vRealize Automation is a hybrid cloud automation platform that transforms IT delivery. Join Mark McCullough in our new course, Professional VMware vRealize Automation, for a trip down the V rabbit hole of everything that you need to know about this platform and how you can use it to deliver pretty much anything as a service, from virtual machines to full business applications, regardless of where those resources live. This course is a really great way to learn vRealize Automation and prep for the Professional VMware vRealize Automation 7.6 exam with a focus on getting hands-on with the technology. Now, hot off the heels of our Deep Racer series, we are excited to announce our next original series, DeepComposer. Brought to you by machine learning hero and Alexa champion Keisha Williams, this 6-episode series is going to help you develop your machine learning skills as you compose a brand new original music track using generative AI and the AWS DeepComposer device. Who knows, maybe you'll even score a recording contract. Maybe not, but it never hurts to dream big, right? Between 2005 and 2014, around 1.7 billion people were affected by earthquakes, floods, fires, and other natural and non-natural disasters. That's a lot of people. In our latest episode of The Future of Tech, Lars Klint looks at how technology is helping reduce that number and save more lives. It's really worth checking out. Travis Rouse's new release review rounds out our VMware extravaganza this month with a deep look at VMware Cloud on AWS, the integrated cloud offering developed by VMware and AWS together. Travis explores what it is, how it enhances native VMware Cloud capabilities through AWS, and how you can use it to quickly extend your current software-defined data center into a hybrid cloud solution. After digging into the details, we'll jump into a demo, and then we'll wrap up the review with our pros and cons and our verdict. We've also got two new Azure Fireside chats to watch, where Lars sits down with Azure experts Adi Polak and Amy Kapernick, as well as new installments of GCP this month and Kubernetes this month. And as always, you can turn to AWS this week and Azure this week to keep up with all the major developments and releases from the two largest public cloud platforms. Beyond our new courses and series, we're also adding two new practice exams to the exam simulator this month for AWS Advanced Networking Specialty and Google Certified Professional Cloud Network Engineer. Head over to the exam simulator and check them out. They're really cool. Finally, for our ACG for Business members, we've recently rolled out a new Teams feature that allows admins to group various cohorts into a team, filter reports, assign learners to a specific team, and more. Teams also creates the role of team coordinators who can now view usage reports and add students to study groups and learning paths at the team level without having full admin privileges across the organization. The team coordinator role helps admins delegate more run-of-the-mill duties and enables teams to take greater ownership over their own skills development. Admins can check out the new Teams feature in their dashboard right now. Okay, well, that about wraps it up for this month's edition of What's New at Cloud Guru. Keep an eye out for more updates. And until then, stay safe, keep learning, and keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus. Thanks.